morning, everybody. at least right now, it's the morning. This is Slimming Down Weight Loss Journey. And just kind of wanted to bring you guys up to date where I've been the last few weeks. So I believe the last video I did was like a couple days after I had quit drinking Dr. Pepper. So the good news on that is I stayed with that. Tuesday, April 4th, I was at work and I got news that my mother had passed away. So hasn't been the easiest of times. So, you know, I took care of all that, honored my mom with a really beautiful service and everything else, and we laid her to rest Tuesday. And so I gotta get, you know, you can't stay down at this level. It's just not healthy. And so she's in my heart and I love her, and I'm really proud of, you know, all that she gave to my brother and I and our family, my husband, our boys, my father-in-law and everything else. She was very, very just a great lady, and she made me, you know, who I am today. Drove me to be better every single day, and that is a goal. It's just to continue to get better. And you know, I can't continue to mope around and that kind of thing. So wanted to get back kind of in motion. And one of those ways of getting back in motion is to, you know, continue with my journey and some news on the update there. Since I quit Dr. Pepper, I've lost weight and I'm now below 200 pounds. I weigh 198.6, so that's a good thing to celebrate. And you can tell that we're outside today because I know I had mentioned I was going to share the gardens, and it's a real appropriate time to share the gardens. I always wait until after Good Friday, and that was yesterday, before I do any planting with a vegetable or even flowers. And it's just been a really good rule of thumb passed down from my grandparents to me, and so this is just going to be harder because usually this time of the season my mom would come out and help me with some of this, and it was something that we did together. So there is going to be a patch in the garden that is going to be in one of the flower gardens that my mom used to help me with quite a bit. That is going to be, you know, kind of like her dedication area. So, but what I'm going to do here in a minute is kind of take you around and show you some little spots of little gardens and stuff like that I have. And I've done a little bit more work a couple weeks back getting the garden prepared. I had added some extra weed barrier and that kind of thing for some of the seams that were, you know, allowing weeds to protrude and that kind of thing. So just kind of buckling it down, getting it better. So if you're ready, let's go ahead and we'll go take a couple of look-sees at the garden areas and where I'm gonna start today working. Kind of chose the west side of the big barn because I didn't want the sun just like beaming in my eyes. And I always try to work in the garden with a visor. It's just good to do that. Kind of keep the sun off your face. You know, you want to protect your skin. I got a low lotion and that kind of thing on. But it's going to be a pretty warm, beautiful day. So, you know, sporting the old tank top. And what's cool is the pants are actually starting to fall loose. So I know I'm finally making that progress. I think I'm down around 15 pounds now total since December 26th when I started the journey. It's not that fast, but it got a little bit faster that week that I quit the Dr. Pepper. But I haven't been working out since the Monday night before I found my mom passed. I did like a Pilates workout, and then since Tuesday the 4th, I have not done a single workout. I have been so busy with taking care of my mom. So let's get to it. So first of all, I can't even tell you how weird this is trying to do this. But so this part of the garden, this is actually for our dog Pete that passed away some years ago. It's kind of like his memorial, and it's a big beautiful yellow knockout rose, and it really had a lot of dead branches and stuff. I didn't get around to pruning it last fall, so as you see, I got some work to do here. Spruce that back up. We have here, this is kind of like the beginning of the big driveway, and we have a lot of creeping phlox. So my creeping phlox here is it's probably in its sixth or seventh year bloom. This is beautiful how it spreads and everything. Kind of give you a little tour. So this one, this bed is pretty much finished. I did most of this the past fall because this has got a lot of bulbs and everything in it. But I got a, what I'm going to do with the old tree stump there is I'm going to stain that and fix that and put more flowers inside there. It'll be really, really beautiful. So here again, have some more spring bulbs. They're already done, sadly, because I had some really gorgeous, fancy different species of daffodils. I have the, that's a hydrangea. It's a gorgeous one when it comes up. It's very blue. I did a lot of splits this past fall. One of them is like Candy Tuft right here. See it coming, and then I got the Larope and Snow and Summer. It's gonna be a gorgeous, big, huge, white, beautiful plant when it bushes out. Some of it is still just really young because it's only, you know, mid-April. Some new fresh barrier with mulch. There's my old dog, one of them. He's a good coyote dog. This boy's one of our big old oak trees. And it's strong. We lost some oak trees here. We got the mums. Pretty good. A lot of lilies. I split the lilies quite often, usually in the fall. Sometimes I'll do a little bit of splitting in the spring. Today I'll be splitting probably some more of the phlox. and stuff. Those are the gladiolas. They're gorgeous gladiolas too. They're beautiful. Like, they're a real bright, like, reddish orange. And, you know, I got the hostas coming up there. Several little different types of flowers coming up everywhere. There's some balloon flowers right there. And they're pretty. I like balloon flowers. Kind of a delicate flower. And then there's a cedar that I'm, like, just grooming and trimming. So I found a couple other little cedars that I'm going to transplant and do the same, because I'm really liking how that's looking. So, as you can see, I got a lot of work. Got my mulch here. Probably going to need more than that, but it's a good start anyway. I really had the bed overfilled in the truck. More creeping fox, butterfly bush, larope. And I may say these words the wrong way, so please forgive me. Little fox. I spread it, and then, you know, I got some sedum over here. I love the ones that ground cover spread. And then look at this little cute flower. So my husband's great-grandmother had, like, all these tons of beautiful little flowers everywhere. So I try to preserve them every time I find them, somehow, some way. More lilies, hostas. A lot of work, as you can see. Got to repair, and then I got to still get leaves out of this area. Enjoy the gardens, and then you get to see the fruit of your labor. You just gotta tend to it. The sedum, another big oak tree. Pretty. Another stupid weed bush that needs to come out. Not a fan of the weed bushes, but, you know, it's just natural. I gotta take care of their dead limbs. Just kind of give you an idea. And I also take stills, so that way I can have, like, some pretty good before and after, but also want to, like, show a video. Oh, it's one of our little babies. And I got a fern that's getting kind of swallowed up in there. I had some new fronds. Excited about that. I get really excited to see first things at the plant. Cars, bicyclists driving their dogs crazy out here. Just kind of give you a little walksy around. Transplant it underneath. It makes it a lot easier to do that way. Oh, so here's one of those little cedars. Hopefully you can see that there. Yeah. Now I will transplant that and I will groom it like I do the other one. So just a gardening on a lot cheaper budget. I used to spend so much money, and I still do spend quite a bit. Split my plants and do it a lot cheaper. I don't know if you can really see the pretty yellow flowers that we have, just, like, in abundance in our yard. It's really pretty. So here is a cannas, and I see my cannas is spreading. That's good, but I'm likely going to use those starts somewhere else. A bunch. Check this out here. Where a big old tree had died, and we had a big old stump, and we got that out there. So another new garden site. These have been here forever. These are daffodils. Unfortunately, they're not here for Easter this year. They're already done. And this is from the great grandma. special little IR spot, because this is from, these are like really old heirloom irises that came from my husband's grandma's garden. She was a heck of a gardener. Beautiful, beautiful, years and years. We actually got married at her place. This lilac here is like really, really old and ginormous. Beautiful. Smells just amazing too. More daffodils. His grandma put in years ago. Spirea ponies. Drainage problem here, so it was looking really, really pretty, and then we had to redo some work here. So some nice bushes in there, heavily bamboo and some others, a rose bush that I hope we still have, but we may have lost it this go round. Finally, rose bush coming back. Another little tea rose. These ones here you can actually cut. They're gorgeous. This is a gooseberry. And then I make a gooseberry pie when they're all nice and done. This prehistoric elephant ear that comes out of there. Crepe myrtles. So I've lost some ferns that I had in there. It's kind of a lot of pay to fix all that. And then I'll do kind of like a thing about up here on the patio, because I'm going to have to redo all my cushions and stuff like that. And I'll get it all spruced up for the season. This is another dill I usually plant like begonias in. Way, drainage, got a lot of repair work to do. Nestos, cushions. I mean, it wasn't here when everybody moved in here. This is a gorgeous little garden area. Tore it down in the fall and rebuilt it up. So that's a little split phlox that's already doing really, really well coming in there. And the balloon flower. The plants are all pretty much here. I only split it a few and added. It all came from my own garden. Oh man, the lilac smell. Spearmint and hopefully that, or chocolate mint, and hopefully that was not a bad idea, because now I've learned that sucker, man, they get a little intrusive ground cover, but the split worked. Okay, more creeping phlox and just some of the old irises. It's so pretty, they're blooming out, and the chair there, it's nice, good for tomorrow Easter. Ginormous. is gorgeous. I can't believe it's already blooming. It makes me excited. Alright. We already got to start spraying. Gosh dang. See these little humdinger of mite things painting the tail into a gardener and destroy your vegetable garden in no time flat and plants. Period. So here we got more creeping phlox and lilies and freesia and tiger lilies. Of course, it's got a big old beautiful lilac. That was a start some years ago that I did planted there. And so I split up some creeping phlox and planted it there. It doesn't look so pretty right now because it's going to have to settle in. Wisteria that the grandma had here. This is our chicken pen and stuff that our husband and the boys and I built together a couple years ago, so they can come in and out of there. And I think I'm going to start refraining them back to that and only out in the yard when we can watch them and show them off in the gardens. So it's an old chicken house and we turned it back into old chicken house. And we built the shutters in there and everything. And it actually has like a grated. Oh, it just shut on us. And it has a lock because you got to keep vermin out. Because they did, we had one get in the pen and slaughter the house. Okay, so here she is, the big garden. This is the vegetable and has some herbs in it. Let's see where a couple weeks ago, that's been more than a couple, but my husband and I, we fixed this. This is grape and blackberry vine. They're looking pretty good. Strawberries there, lemon balm. Got some preen and I will use that. Looking good and healthy. I mean, we've already got like parsley. People didn't know that that's actually perennials, if you didn't know that. This species is. And then I have oregano and the mint. Chives, there's strawberries, and the lemon balm. And the blackberries are looking really good. So I'll be extensifying this and building more of this out because I really want more berries. They're really good for a healthy diet. Oops, it's pretty uneven in here. That's bee balm here, and then that is sage. And then we have lemon thyme and German thyme and oregano, Greek oregano. But as you can see, here she is. She's pretty close to ready. I pre-punched some holes in that first one, as you can see. I'm going to do a little little bit differently. I may not, I'm not adding the same number of holes that I had on the edge last year. So that's why I kind of redid it over there. Problem solving, you know. Figured out years over years of gardening. And then I got that section that I need to, man, I just got a lot of work. Mr. Owl. So I hope you enjoyed the tour of the gardens. I'm gonna go ahead and take the stills now so that way I have a starting point, you know, for the before and after. Because there's a lot of work, as you can see, to be done around the farm, so I can keep you all busy if you like this gardening and stuff like that, to see how it all kind of evolves over time. I think I forgot to show you like my little cabin office area porch, but I have a lot of flowers there and stuff from my mom's funeral that are going to go in the garden, and then I'll have them all like kind of spread around and that kind of thing. Little finch. But hope you enjoy this, and it's got a lot of work to get going, so I will see you all soon. Take care, and yeah, bye. Digging.
they have heavy blossoms and that kind of thing. So what I did was I took a little bucket off the pot and I put the little support around because it's very windy here. So next thing you want to do, already take the plant, fly drained out of the pot. You want to just kind of rough up very slightly around the edges, the roots, so they can start to connect and grow into the soil around it. Make sure your plant has a good, healthy start. So I've got the first hydrangea in the garden, as you can see right there, and I just put the mulch around it, so it'll make it a little bit more stable, and it's a beautiful color, the little pink and white, really, really pretty. All right, so next I'm going to put in the blue hydrangea. Okay, so I have all the hydrangeas in, and so I have the pink, a blue, and then a darker pink, and then I have rainbow mums. And now I've got to go ahead and fill in the back parts of these plants with mulch, and then I'm going to do some starts of some creeping phlox and probably some sedum, as well as probably a little bit of candy tuft. And